Good morning, everybody. I am going to try again to make this tutorial for the Snapchat filter that I've been playing with. This one kind of really got me started into it. Every time I try to make this tutorial, I keep getting interrupted by dogs. So I'm at work, so hopefully there's no dogs that's going to interrupt me. So here is going to be the tutorial. So let me know if you have any questions. After the fact, I'll be going over step by step on some of the things like what to focus on, what not to focus on, because it can be overwhelming if you're new to it. And just have some fun with it. That's like my biggest takeaway. Have fun. Okay. Don't get frustrated. Just have fun. So let's go ahead and get started. Move this down. Actually, I'm going to go ahead and close that. Okay. So this is Lens Studio. The first thing that you will need to do to create Snapchat filters is download Lens Studio. And so it's lensstudio.snapchat.com, and then you click the download button. If you don't have good internet, this could be an issue to download. You need to have good internet to download it. You don't necessarily need good internet to play with it and to create. But to actually do the download, you do need to have good internet. Okay. So I don't have very good internet at home. And what I did, went to the library, downloaded it. It only took a couple of minutes. Okay. So this is Lens Studio. After you get it downloaded, you know, this is the interface for Lens Studio. Now, the assumption being made if you're watching this video is that you're familiar with Snapchat and how it works. Like you have the app already on your phone, you have an account and all that stuff. So right now I'm already signed in to mine. If you weren't signed in, like when you initially download it, you won't be signed in. There should be like yellow, something about connect to your Snapchat account. So you would need to do that. On the left-hand side is home, templates, and documentation. The documentation is pretty good. The frustration is like if you're not familiar with some of the terminology and just, you know, that can be kind of overwhelming, but overall it is pretty good once you start getting used to it. On the left hand side also, if you go further down, you can do new project or open project, and some recent projects that I've done, you can see here on the left hand side. So yours would most likely be blank right now. So the way I started actually playing with Snapchat is just playing with the templates, and that's how I increased my confidence and my skill set. And you know, my experience with Snapchat filters, and start just, you know, playing with it and being creative and being curious. So we're going to do that. We're going to start with the templates. So we're going to click on templates. You can see some of my recently used templates, but let's scroll all the way down here. You can see all the templates, and we are going to scroll all the way down to find Team Celebrate. This is the one we're going to be focusing on for this tutorial. So you can click learn more, and you can see the complexity level is fairly low. So that's good to get started with. It allows you to create a sports themed team celebration lens. A template comes with configurable face paint and confetti, which you can recolor. And if you click on here, there's a video and guide. I'm not going to click on it, but that will actually take you to like the video and documentation, which again, it's pretty useful, you know, check it out. But for our purposes, we're just going to hit start project, and it's going to load. Okay, so this is the layout that you're going to come to for what we're going to be for this filter we're going to be creating. On the left hand side, you'll see there's objects and resources. In the middle area, you can see there's like a grid. For our purposes on this particular filter, that's not going to be a focus area. On the right hand side, you'll see inspector. This is not something we'll be focusing on for this particular filter. This is where we're going to be putting most of our focus and their attention on to be customizing it. And over on the far right hand side, you can see a preview. You can work with some of the display. Like right now, this is kind of scrunched up for the computer that I'm on. Let's see. You can play with that a little bit. If you go to window and click on panels, you can also play with what you see and what you don't see. But this is the default layout, and I'm just going to leave it like that right now. So what we're going to be focusing on on the left-hand side under objects, you can see where it says team controller, team celebrate controller, and it says edit me. So Snapchat filters, they are in the templates, they give you some direction on what to edit, what to remove. Like right here, it says remove me. But we're going to be focusing on team celebrate controller edit me. So make sure you have that selected. And then on the right-hand side, you'll be seeing some of the things that we're going to be playing with. So on the preview, you can see by default, and your screen may look a little bit differently than what mine is, but you should be able to see the preview on the right-hand side. But anyway, so you can see what it looks like. It's got this logo over on the top right corner over my eye. It's got the vertical three colors, and you can see goal in the banner on the bottom. So what we're going to do first is we are going to change our primary colors. So you can do the primary colors with whatever color you want. Down here on the bottom, I have custom colors for Hockey and College. They're hex values, so I'm just going to use that. You can use whatever colors that you like. If you have a particular color theme for your school or sport or whatever it is, you can make that as well. You just need to find those hex values, and then you can input them in here. But I already have it here, so I'm going to go ahead and do this one for Hockey and College blue. The secondary color, I'm going to do the Hockey and College green. Now the tertiary color is the third color, and you can say if you want a color, and you can see it just changes it from the red to just the blue and the green. Or you can have the third color, it's up to you. And because Hockey and College does have three colors, I'm gonna put that orange in there. So for the team logo, now this is just, I like to use PNG files because they have a transparent background, but any image file should work. You click on this little image logo and click Add New and Import Files. And Donut Day is coming up, I think next week, so I've been working on something for Donut Day. And find the files. There we go. That's not what I want. There we go. Okay. So I have the Hawking College logo here. It's a PNG file, like I said, meaning it's going to have the transparent background. Okay. You can do a JPEG if you want. It's really up to you. Hit okay. And you can see that the logo has already changed. On the top right-hand corner, it now says the Hawking College Computer Sciences. You can't really see it that closely because of the color scheme. But you can see it's over my left eye as well. My right, yeah, left eye as well. The logo. So on the confetti, we can have confetti or not have confetti, but we want confetti because confetti is fun. The face paint. Oh, okay. And the confetti intensity. You can make it more intense, or you can scroll it down to make it just a little sprinkling of confetti. But we want heavy confetti. You can customize the confetti color if you want. You'll notice that by default, it looks like it does have all three colors. But if you only wanted a couple different colors, if you want it just for some contrast or whatever, you can customize the colors to different colors. But if you wanted to just kind of keep with the theme that you have right up here, you can just leave it unchecked. Face paint, you can show face paint. Or not show face paint, you know, but I'm on face paint. And then you can do the layout of the face paint. Like right now, it's the default of the vertical three. You can select lines, which kind of looks like, you know, lines underneath, like kind of like for sports and football and stuff. You can select swirls, which is kind of cool. I've used that a few times. You can do half, not a fan of this. Quarter. Not a fan of that. Vertical three, which is the default, not a fan of that. Horizontal three, not a fan of that. So I like the lines. Okay. And again, you can customize the colors If you want a different kind of colors, you can. If I'm going to leave it the default, the green and the blue, because I don't like the orange. You can show the face logo. So you can see, like I said earlier, it's over my left eye. If you don't want it, you can turn it off. Oh, sorry, screen logo. I got ahead of myself. Wait a minute, what did I do? Face logo. Yeah, okay. Face logo, you can see, turn it off and it goes away. But we want it on because that's what's fun about this filter. You can do it over the left eye, right eye. You can see it's changing. Now I can't see the screen. Full face. I don't like that. Left cheek. Okay, you can't really see it because of the stripes. So you would kind of say, do we want that or not? Those are the things that you can customize. Right cheek. And both cheeks. Okay. But I like the left eye. I just like the left eye because it kind of goes with the curve of the eyebrow. And I just like it. You can how strong and how weak you want it to be, how transparent, but well, that's strong. Okay. So here's the screen logo. So the screen logo sits on the top right hand corner, and you can keep it on or turn it off. It's up to you on that. And want to keep it on. And the position, you can have the top right, top left, top middle. And then you can do the same things on the bottom. I'm not going to go through all of that. Let's see. You can do basically where the alpha, where it's like very, you can see it, or it's more transparent. My lens is being reset. See, now it's gone. My phone dinged. The logo size, you can play with the size of the logo. Now, this is just affecting the screen logo, not the face logo. The offset of the X axis, which is side by side. Yeah, I'm going across. You can play with that, the positioning of it. On the Y axis, which is up and down, you can play with the positioning of that as well. Okay, for the banner, which is where it says gold down here, I don't have a banner that I want to use in its place, so I'm just actually going to take off. Okay, if you wanted a banner, you can do the similar process as we did up here, just changing it to image file. Audio. So one, the ones that I've been making, I've been adding an audio file to it. Now the audio file has to be a small enough size. In my experience, usually you want an audio clip that's about 30 seconds long, because if you get into like a full range song, like 3 or 4 minutes, the file size is too large. And there is a file capacity maximum on Snapchat to be published. So first time me doing this, I did full song and it was just too large of a file. So I just been grabbing, going online and having a safe download of an MP3 file from a source that I trusted not to give me a virus, and adding that. So let's go ahead and find an audio track. So the one that I've been using is Celebrate. Oh, here it is. Cool the Gain Celebration. Hit OK. Okay, that went a little screwy there, but you get the idea. So you can adjust the volume. So I'm turning it down because I'm trying to talk. And you can loop it, which basically means once the song ends, it'll repeat itself. I think this song is about 30 seconds long, so it just depends on how long you want it. And so that's pretty much it. I'm going to go ahead and turn this volume back up and mute this. I don't know why it's being so screwy right there. but it's been working. That's the same audio file I've been using for everyone, so it works. But anyways, so now you can preview. It's on the top right-hand corner. This is after you've already connected to your Snapchat account. You can do push, and we're going to send it to the Lens server. We're going to send it to the Snapchat server. And give it a minute or two. So let's see. So while this is still thinking, on the right, let's kind of go over this pane a little bit, the interface. On the left-hand side, you can see resources. So there's some default stuff in here that already came with. And then you can see as we added files like the Hawking College Computer Science, oh, there it is. You can see it being added in there. So you can see, I don't know if you saw it or not, but it says it was pushed to the server. And I got a notification saying, you know, your lens is ready for preview. And then you just do the normal Snapchat stuff. Trying to see if the audio's on. Make sure I got my volume turned up. There we go. So you can see so it's previewed, we like it, we're happy with it, yay, we made a filter. So on the left hand side, project info, we are going to give it our project info. Boom, 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 boom. So the lens name was Celebrate, was the template. So let's do Hawking College. Because there is a max on how many characters, so I usually have to abbreviate a bunch of stuff. Hawking College Celebrate. Hawking College Computer Science Celebrate. Okay. So it does talk about here, maximum allowed lens size is 4 megabytes. So that's why I was talking about earlier. Don't do the whole song. Just do a 30 second snippet of it. You can use it for front or rear camera. So you saw whenever I was previewing earlier, when I switched the camera to the rear or front, whatever I did, then you can still see it. But if you only want it to be front camera, rear camera use, you can just select it or deselect it. Not familiar with spectacles, so I'm not venturing into that. Some of the filters that I've also created that I can continue to make some tutorial videos on is like something you need to show your hand. Those have been fun. But you can give some sort of hint, like show your hand or say something or something. Playing with the audio is fun too, like the voice. There's a lot of fun stuff to do with this. But for this one, don't really need a hint. So I'm not doing a hint. On the icon, you can select a custom icon. So what I've been doing is just grabbing something for this. Sometimes I create something custom for, you know, using Canva, but for this particular video, I'm not. I'm just going to do something like that. Put it wherever.
Hey, Tasha. Tasha, you're so nice. Thank you.
You're welcome. And hit apply, and then you hit publish. Okay, so it's thinking. Boom, 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 boom. All right. Pause this while I was thinking. Okay, So confirm submission. You can add some tags into it if you like. Like, want to add Hocking College. You can't add spaces in there. So celebration. And triggers, like, you know, I've done one with a dog. That was fun. But this one, you need the trigger for it to be a person. You can do a preview of the lens. I don't do that anymore because you have to take a picture of yourself and then upload it. And it's a pain in the butt. Don't do it. But you can if you want. Hit submit. Okay, so then you can see your lenses, you know, how many, their total reach, total views, total plays, total shares, and you can see the lenses that you made, you know, previously. So you can see I've had some fun with it for small businesses, for my favorite movie, for a birthday, for Guy County opening back up. There's some more down here. I got in trouble for one, for Spider-Man, because I guess I used a copyrighted image. So just be careful on that. So I've been kind of creating my own images on Canva and Figma and stuff, but that's another video. So what's going to happen next, right? You can see where some of these say live. This one, the one we just created, says in review. And what's going to happen is next is you're going to get an email to the email that's associated with your Snapchat account. And it's going to say it's approved, hopefully, and that it's live. And then you can share it, the lens with, you know, other people. And it gives you instructions in that. But this is how you create one of my favorite Snapchat filters. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out and let me know. Thank you.